Now, this film, of course, has Frank Sinatra in a very big role, and Sinatra had, you know, not only grave reservations about the release of the film in the wake of Kennedy's assassination, he had the film shelved for quite a while. How does somebody do that?
That was basically a myth. I spoke 2 days ago to Bob Finkelstein, who manages the Sinatra estate and has for many years, with a guy named Mickey Rudin, who I know you've heard of. And originally, when that film was made, Arthur Krim, who was the head of United Artists, really hated it. Arthur Krim was a really strong Democrat. And he thought that the message of the film was very dangerous, and he didn't like the film. Sinatra knew President Kennedy and called him. And Kennedy knew the book, The Manchurian Candidate. And he was curious about who was going to play the mother. And Sinatra told him it was Angela Lansbury. He said, very interesting. And then Sinatra asked him to call Arthur Krim, head of United Artists. And Kennedy called Arthur Krim and said, you know, Arthur, I love this novel, and I'm very anxious to see the film. Shortly after the film was released, Kennedy was assassinated. Contrary to the myth, it was not pulled out of release. It played just a few years later on television. But like anything else, they weren't putting classic movies right back into cinemas. But it's had a long shelf life. It was never really banned or suggested that it be banned by the government. But that is a story that got around.